like technical, anything, you know.
But I'm not dressed for being.
No, no, that's okay. Well, we're tech. Can answer, okay. No, we're tech guys. We're supposed to be.
Okay.
So, so what was the beginning to set this up? I mean, why the center? Why? How did you? Did you do some measurements or something like that? The sound
actually,
quality?
Actually, we were here in observation at about May, I think. Yeah. We were here and we did some stuff. We measured everything and we tried to realize if our vision, what was on the paper, will fit in here and how it will look like. So we just tried to accommodate the structure and all the electricity and everything like that must be prepared in for our visit here and for our beginning installation. So,
ooh. And so how long was the planning stage?
Actually, the first sketch of the cube and I think the proposal that Jan should say was something in the beginning of the year. But my first visit for the technical details was something in the beginning of May, I think.
Beginning of May. And what made you decide a cube configuration instead of a different configuration?
Actually, we are used to do it like that all the time if it's possible and the client requires nothing else. So I think 360 degrees cube can bring a lot of opportunities for the in-house to create a great entertainment for the visitors and make it attractive so the people can look at it and they're interested in it. And it brings a little more expectations maybe and more help me with the word
it's a lot better for the advertising. It's, you know, it really enables the advertising to go to the next level, having the board be 360,
because those that just believe
around.
You that the people are staring at the cube at the right time, so they have no other chance just to make a better advertising there, so that really helps all the stadium. And
And how many systems is actually working at one time here?
How do you mean that?
How many platforms? Is it XP? Is it
Windows 7 base and Windows servers. Depends if workstation or servers. But I think we have seven servers here. Seven servers, some kind of network infrastructures and controllers. And
oh my gosh. Oh man. And how much power is actually going through here?
20 kilowatts just here.
Oof. Oh,
including
yeah.
The sound.
And the sound too.
Cube is around 130 kWs.
Oof. And it's green friendly. That's what they were mentioning.
Yeah, it's the energy, the consumption is very low comparing to the others. And the thing is that it's very low weight, so it's about half of a weight regular cube in this size we have.
And this is a constant, ongoing learning process, you know.
Actually, yes,
it's a brand new system.
In recent
days,
we just trained a couple of guys here with Joseph, tried to learn them the basics of how the system works, and later on we will continue with the more advanced step and more advanced. So we will be back here, I think, 1 week before the opening night to make sure that it's prepared well and to show them even more advanced stuff. But we'll be still helping them through internet and Skype and whatever it's just need. So we'll take care of them just to have the entertainment that it should be, the best of all you can get here.
I'm going to recommend to Pat to have like a small blog in the website to say, you know, technical updates.
Okay, that's fine.
That would be fun.
And everything absolutely depends on how guys will be updating the graphics and the visual stuff, because they have opportunity to do almost everything on the cube, so they could change the complete style, the complete color schemes and everything every minute of the game, so they can make attractive content on that. So.
Well, thank you for your time and consideration. Okay, any last words for the fans?
That's for us. So enjoy the hockey, enjoy the SF Bulls, and just make sure that you will come here every time the game is taking place here. Bye.